What's up? Bob here, and as promised, I'm going to bring you guys up to speed on all the trading that I did last week. As you can see, behind me is my pedal board, and there are quite a few new items on the board. All I can say about that is new pedals day, as in plural. Also, a quick update on the Sir Alt T. The body is very light on this guitar, and as a result, for purposes of quick demonstration, when you stand with it, sometimes it just does this. So, you know, you do spend some of your time kind of holding it up by the neck. So when you're playing, it's a little tough. Also, I'm not used to, I see these pickups as lukewarm water. I kind of like things that are hot or cold. They're great when you're all by yourself, but in a band setting, it can be kind of frustrating. So, that's how that's going. Otherwise, this thing is pretty awesome. On to the main event. Quite a few new things on the board. I'm going to go ahead and switch perspectives and talk about that now. Oh. So, as you can see, there are some new items here on the board, and I will address the elephant in the room first. The two Pete Cornish pedals that are sitting here. One is a SS2, that I believe that stands for soft sustain, and then the other one is a G2. Both of these pedals are widely used by all sorts of giants of the industry. I would say that the SS2 is more of a traditional kind of an overdrive with a slight mid hump, not very much. And the G2 is a very think a whole lot of love, actually. Tone just pops right out of there. So it can be very Jimmy Page. It can be rat-like, muff-like. It's a very interesting pedal. These are the professional series ones. So they have the big kind of, I don't know what you call that, like a military-grade switch. And the battery compartment, tuner outs, and the whole nine. Pretty great pedals. They're very open sounding. No mid hump really on either of them. So they're not really... they're very clear sounding and will expose you if you don't have your shit together. Because basically... they're not giving you all those juicy frequencies that we're used to hearing out of a lot of other pedals. Now, next is, we'll get to this in a minute. Next is, I put the El Capistan delay back on the board here. If you've been watching the vlog for very long at all, and you are familiar with the Ode introduction, the L cap, it was featured in the beginning of that when it starts to oscillate. You hold this down and it starts to oscillate. I used that pedal from the day it came out and used it to record a lot of stuff in 2015. And it was just time it made a comeback. Now, this spot here is generally used for auditioning pedals, or in this case, I just need a pedal that does reverse, so it's just hanging out. Also have some other, like there's another power jack here, just in case I want to throw some other things in the mix and whatnot. So basically, we got the Cornish pedals, these beautiful things here. The L cap is back, and last but not least, if you've seen enough of these, you'll know that I used to have a octave pedal, or an octave up pedal, in a Lemonheads 10. Well, it was pretty cool and all, but you really couldn't step on it without crushing it. So I rehoused that pedal into this enclosure this weekend, and it came out beautifully, so I'm really super happy about that. So it's on the board, and now I have all my very Hendrixian herbs available at all times. So essentially, folks, this is what the big board is looking at right now. Let me change perspectives and we'll talk about it just a little bit more. So, now that the cat is out of the bag, I'll go through all the pedals as, you know, one at a time. As the vlogs go on, you know, I'll try to get to one this week and then start doing the rest of them. I mean, there's only four, shouldn't take very long. And there are more to come, actually. I have a few more that I have been waiting on. So, you know, these things usually have waiting lists and stuff, depending on what you're getting. But that said, you know, that is not my gigging board. But I usually use this at rehearsals, so you'll get to hear most of those if you watch the rehearsals. So do that, and you'll get kind of a sneak peek before the demos, you know. I would like to say that just because, you know, there's a bunch of expensive pedals on the board, it doesn't mean that I'm always going to like them or get along with them. To be honest, those Cornish pedals have presented a lot of challenges to me that I wasn't really expecting. They're somehow, they have a lot of gain available, but yet they're kind of really clear sounding, and there's not very much mids, and so, it's
different because I was using a Zen Drive a lot, which is like very mids up front and just like in your face, kind of everything you need when you're soloing and stuff like that. So this is a whole different thing. And they are big sounding pedals, really, really big. I did a comparison the other day, which I would do for you guys, with a Tube Screamer, and the Tube Screamer sounded so small compared to the SS2. So I can't wait to show you that. But that said, I am still using the pedal board of the gods. It's down here on the floor. Make no mistake, it's gone nowhere. It's right there. Fuzz Face, Echozar, the whole deal. Don't get it twisted, okay, folks? That's not going anywhere. So, probably hit you with a little bit of a rehearsal, and then, or maybe a demo, probably of the what I'm calling the Red Ringer, the pedal that I rehoused this weekend. So, stay tuned for that.
hold this together a little bit.